Shaking the pen, baby. Hello, everybody. Welcome to another great episode of What Did You Write Today? For those who don't know, What Did You Write Today is an insight into the writing process of me, Steve Whalen, Mr. Jokes. So what we usually do, and what we're doing today, is we're taking one word and we're breaking it down and seeing what makes it funny. Today's word is calendar. The reason why I selected it was because we did a writing session recently where I think the idea was something like Late Show or, you know, The Tonight Show, something like that, making jokes about that. And we kind of got hung up on the original idea, but one thing I thought was funny was the idea of a calendar. In fact, I even posted a status on my Facebook that was a spoof of an old poem. I posted, "For Sale Comedian's Calendar Never Used," and it got over 100 likes in 24 hours, which is always the sign of a good joke, even though that's more of a tweet. So we're going to listen to some music. And we're going to get to writing, so please leave a comment, like, share. I'm going to actually make this video public right now. So let's see what we got. All right, as long as you can see me. Matthew Easton, how are you? Let's make this public so people can share it. Oh, I'm caught in a little bit of a loop. So, please like, share, and subscribe. I'm going to be giving out shout-outs and such to people who post and like and comment, and even if you tune in. So right now, the song we're listening to, and let me know if it's a little bit too loud. Doesn't sound that bad. We are listening to Charles Mingus. For all you, Mingus plays piano. Perhaps for all you Sonic fans, you might know him as Charles Mingus. But other than that, so we're just posting a few things. Then we're going to get ready to jot down some ideas lightning fast. But please like, share, subscribe, comment, run some jokes by me, even if it's a joke that you don't necessarily like. I love punching up jokes. I love hearing jokes. Let's write some stuff real quick. We're going to run with the white pen. So the first thing I think of when I think of a calendar is I think of date. That's sort of the basic one, right? And then there's the month. We put out other ideas that we think are more fruitful, and then we take ideas from that. So let's see, calendar, date. I'm going to write down, book. meaning booked as in like a comedian, the way a comedian gets booked. Busy.
Music's a little bit loud even for me.
Busy, successful. Calendar. I think successful can be its own category. Like the signs of a good calendar. It's full, right? What else? It's full. There's a lot of writing on it. Organized. See, we can still get something wacky out of something that seems very ordinary, like a calendar. Joan Rivers, the late Joan Rivers, has a great joke. The joke that I think of immediately when I think of calendars, which is, I have to wear sunglasses when I look at my calendar because all the white is bad for my eyes. And then maybe we'll look into the mechanics of what makes it work. So we'll write down the mechanics. Sort of the literal things, right? How it's white. It's the boxes. There's numbers. One through 12, right? It's in order. You might not think there's anything we can see there, but when we use our cheat sheet, we might think of something funny with an opposite. I'm going to underline opposite. That's my most used style of joke. If you're booked, you're busy, you're successful, people want to see you. You're on shows. Money. Fame. Hard to find. Oh, Mingus, take me away. So nice to be with you guys here. Thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate it. I might need to take a break and refill that water jug. I should have thought of that before I came down here. Date, month, 30 or 31, right? Leap year. The month, and then, for example, Jan, February. What are some specific types of calendars? Right, there's word of the day. I have a friend, Tynan DeLong, one of his funniest jokes that I love is he says something to the extent of, I have a word of the day calendar. People say, isn't that a little pretentious? And I say, well, that's a little Wednesday of me. Oh, man, that's funny. Oh, something along those lines. I think I shortened it. What are some other specific? There's like cartoon character ones like Garfield and Dilbert. Right? Hang in there. There's recyclable, recycled, I guess. Digital, certainly, everyone. Digital jokes are pretty much a safe bet, no matter who. Because young people know what digital stuff is, and old people don't want to look past it, so they'll laugh. Not too obscure, but they also like the idea of something being made fun of that they don't know too much about. Sort of like the way Weird Al does with current pop culture stuff. Shows, books, we're going to have to start making some connections. Full. You write on it, you organize it, you take notes on your calendar. What are some other things of people with full calendars? They have a Rolodex, an assistant. Clear my calendar, right? I don't know. That's more of a specifics. Clear it. Digital. Anybody else throwing down any ideas? I'm trying to keep the amount of ideas lower because I've done 6 or 7 and people kind of... Andrew Denniser, Dave Fitzgerald, some of my friends. Dad Ass. Oh, Dave, thank you. Block. White pen, yeah. The Mayan calendar. There we go. Look, if I know these Mayan guys, it's not the end of the world, okay? You know what I'm saying? All right. A Mayan calendar. And maybe we can work with that. That suggestion was a favorite of Mayan, Charles. Maybe we can do a sound-alike joke with some calendars. We have pun or sound-alike as our number two option. They're not in any order. They're just from the book The Serious Guide to Joke Writing by Sally Halloway. That's the order in which she listed them. Opposite is my number one go-to. Punter Sound Alike is up there. Thanks for making me feel self-conscious, Dave. I appreciate it. Mayan calendar. What else? Recycled digital. When I think of recycled, I think of like recycled jokes. Successful people. They have an assistant. I need someone to help me with my calendar. Like financial. They cancel. Maybe they cancel on you. That's an opposite. My calendar. I really want to do a joke very similar to that Joan Rivers joke. I have to wear sunglasses when I look at my calendar because all the white is bad for my eyes. That joke is brilliant. So they want to see you, your calendar's full, you're doing like 5 spots a day. Prestigious. Box numbers. My calendar has a We had a joke the other day where it was like I have a reusable calendar, and there's something there where it's like, what's something practical for somebody who doesn't need to throw out their calendar? Something practical for somebody that would not be that normal. Leap year. What are some other dates? And of course, people think of a date like with women. You know, at a fancy restaurant. I'll never learn how to spell restaurant. Let's see. Date, women. That's fine. Book. I'm on 5 spots a day. Yeah. Maybe they have like a dry erase calendar, but that's something funny. Stephen Ignatius joined. There we go. Charles Chiwako with a critic reference. No one's using the word Dukelicious. What a Duketastrophe. It's too bad he passed away. That would have been a fun movie. They were trying to see if they can get a live-action movie together. He would have been great. So anyway, Let's see. Fame book. My calendar is organized by blank. How is it organized? How are calendars, by month. My calendar isn't organized by month, it's organized by blank. I still didn't buy a calendar, folks. It's July. My career's not going well. I still didn't buy a calendar. That's simple, but it could be effective. Boy, if that's not a super bitter Andy Kindler joke. That's one that'll get a sad reaction. This might not be a perfect joke, but this might be something we can use as a foundation. They say mark your calendar. Mark your calendar. My blank. Who would be somebody funny that would mark a calendar? An assistant, an agent, producer, or a venue? I always try to think of like the other worlds of a comedian. Because, like, it's not just the comedian. The comedian sees, like, a venue. They see an agent or a producer. They see audience members. And these are people that live in the world of a comedian that also are important integral parts. Maybe it's not so lonely on stage. I still haven't bought a calendar. I'm saving a lot of money on calendars, people. My career is not going well. I still haven't bought a calendar. Does anybody want a calendar? It's time again. Uh-oh, boom. Give it a little uh-oh when you need to do two things. Bird up. Might single-handedly be the best advice I've ever gotten in writing. Which is where if you have multiple ideas in your writing, just write it. Write the other thing. A ton of mental effort is stopped when people just think of an idea and then they're like, it kills so much momentum. Obviously, the main thing we're linking it is to me having a subpar career. Or perhaps we can even link it with the ladies. My digital calendar went out of print. I don't know what you just... Oh, mark your Mayan calendar with human hearts. Johnny Q. Amish. One of my favorites. Johnny Q. Amish. Comedian I would see in New York. He would have all these colorful phrases and all these funny jokes where it was... what do you say? Every cloud has a silver lining when you're a male prostitute. What was it I used to? I used to stuff a bunch of crackers in my socks and fuck it. Now women pay me to have sex with them for money. Every cloud has a silver lining when you're a male prostitute. Oh, brother. Oh, Johnny. Oh, I hope I did that one justice, Johnny. That was a poem I remember that you wrote. I keep my notes organized. Oh, by the way, Charles Chiwalko, CityBug7 on Instagram. Very cool photographer, social media manager. It's hard to book me. What would make it difficult? Oh, Charles Mingus. I'm feeling good today. I feel like there's a couple of real good ones in here. Oh, look at that. Mingus is talking it up. It's about like playing at home by yourself. Well, what can we do for you? Hang in there. My career is a cat. Let's see what we got. Notes, assistant, agent. Does anybody need a calendar? I think that one is funnier that I still haven't bought a calendar. Does anybody need a calendar? Arbor Day. Maybe a specific holiday might be funny. Ann Arbor Day. Mark your calendar. Kind of reminds you almost of setting a timer. I don't know. Just write all these ideas. Get all the garbage out. Digital calendar. I have a digital calendar. My career is on VHS. I'm just writing down. This is unrelated. I just wrote down video will. That to me is funny. Alright. Completely unrelated. Sometimes you get a funny idea in your head and you just write it down. Video will. A tape of my stand-up was given as a video will, folks. Will or won't. Digital. What's the difference between a digital? Does anybody even... Well, a digital calendar's on a computer. Everyone tells me, invest in Google, invest in Google. I didn't listen to them. I invested in Ask Jeeves. It's an Andy Kindler joke. I invested in a blank... Could be a funny thing to invest in. Well, does anybody need a calendar? Does anybody need a calendar? It's not clear that, whereas I still haven't bought a calendar. Vagina. Eno, bong, shame on you. Shame on you, Eno. Eno Bong showing up. Talk about a bong hit. Oh. I get booked 2 times a day. Blank. I feel like there's something in the potential of the mechanics. Right, you flip it over. What else? You flip it. You write on it. Oh, it's so much fun to be here. The world makes sense here. We do have to start making connections, though. Let me sit down and we'll start making connections. I sit down a little bit, not too much, but it's hot as heck down here. It's all good, Eno. I'm glad you're watching. I came late. What's going on? Hey, that's not unusual for you. Gotcha. Oh, Eno, we're writing joke ideas based on what I've written here. The idea of what's funny about calendars. How can I link it to maybe my career not going well? Maybe something to do with dating? But the main thing is that. So what could be funny... I get booked. My calendar is full. How many? When do calendars sync up again? It's got to be like at least 10 years. We can do a bit of a thoughtful joke. When do calendars repeat? 6 years, 5 years. It's 11-6-5-6. All right, it's 11-6-5-6. So what year is this? 2016? This is a bit of a thinker joke, isn't it? Well, it'll match up exactly 28 years. My career is not going well. Did you know that a calendar can be reused 6 years in the future? You fell asleep by the time that joke was over. Jaws music. The obvious joke is date and date. Eno making his presence felt. Yeah, date and date match. And that's something you can do with a sound-alike joke. And maybe we'll do a dating joke later. Right, what do they have, a little black book? little black book. And for those who don't know, that's something that you write ladies' phone numbers in. It's sort of like a booty call book. I get booked all the time, but not all the time. That's a very specific opposite joke that's a tough nut to crack. My best friend Steven DeSiena has a joke where he says, I lost 6 pounds in 55 months. So I'm thinking, which is very funny, by the way, and I'm thinking about tuning into some of that. Where I got booked 7 times this year, but something a bit snappier. Huh? I'm on 7 shows last year. I'm on 8 shows this year. Maybe I point down and say, I get booked, huh? I'm on 4 shows this year. That's very simple. And who knows, maybe it might work. Ugh. They can't all be gems. I get booked. I'm on 4 shows this year. Can't believe this joke is a two-liner. And it's not even that great. Oh, but that's fine. You know what? Have faith. You gotta have faith. This pen is creamy. Maybe I can do a little Jackie Gleason. Jackie Gleason does one of the funniest things. Sometimes when he is about to yell, he takes like a hand like this and he puts it right here. And it's so funny. Because, you know, oh my God, it's just such like a specific... So sometimes I steal that move. I get booked. I'm on 4 shows this year. Right? Whew. Gleason, baby. If anybody knew how to move, it was Gleason. I got a wedgie in my butt. It's actually okay. I just have a... Oh. This has become self-conscious theater. Big shout out to Matt Morano and Christina Galston. Christina Galston, very funny comedian. She's on shows all the time. I saw her on Petey's World on Saturday or Friday. I think it was Friday. And Matt Morano has a play coming up at the Creek in the Cave. So check that out. And apparently I have a wedgie. I didn't know. I'm going to count that as an extra view, Matt, the fact that, oh, man. Maybe that'll be the next word, wedgie. Ugh, what are you going to do?
I'm glad you said wedgie. Why doesn't he get that out of his butt? I thought there was something trapped down there. All right, let's see what we got. I get booked. I'm on 4 shows this year. My calendar is so empty, blank. I used to do a joke. I still did, but I used to too. I used to do a joke. Oh, by the way, I'm just going to write that down real quick. I used to do a joke where I said, like, I haven't been dating. The last time I used Tinder, dust came out of my phone. So maybe we can apply that here, where it's like my calendar or something is covered in dust. Just something a little punchier. I wrote down MH. I highly recommend this. Mitch Hedberg has a Comedy Central Uncut special. It's his original Comedy Central Presents, but look up Uncut online. It's about 37 minutes. It's the entire Presents Uncut. And normally an uncut special, it's like cut from like 25 to 21 minutes because the audience is so rough around the edges for the first 10 minutes. And Mitch just starts doing all of his jokes, every single joke he ever wrote. He's just standing and doing it, and they edit it together. And there's even some jokes that you really associate as like Mitch's A material that are ones he just thought of later. So as a one-liner comic, it was a really horrific look into the future. Because that's probably how, if I get a Comedy Central Presents, that's probably what's going to happen to me. Is that at some point at the end, they'll be like, can you just say any joke? Oh. That's a pretty big if. Booked as an arrested. Eno, coming through with an actual, with something actually helpful. Love it, Eno. Book is, I got booked for blank. Booked. They threw the book at me. The last time I got booked, they threw the book at me. This is a beautiful album. Oh, man. Leap year. I get booked on leap year, folks. I have a show coming out on leap year. My new show is on the 5th Thursday of every month. I get booked. There we go. Oh, Zach. Woo! Zach Kahn coming through. That is a great joke. Zach, I don't even think I've ever met you in my life. Zach comes and my calendar's so empty, they fit another month in there. Oh, my goodness. That's what I'm talking about. my calendar is so empty. So let's break down empty. Let me get up and see if we can show off the wedgie again. I'm now standing far away. So when I think of empty, of course, I think of full, because that's the most counterproductive. Empty, like a gorge, if that's even correct, or a valley. Oh, echo. Maybe something with an echo? My calendar is so empty, it echoes. My calendar is so empty, you can talk and it will echo. My calendar's so empty, they fit an extra month. I like that. I'm starting to, not gonna lie, I'm starting to like it maybe a little less as I talk, but it's funnier than my echo idea. My calendar is so empty, they fit an extra month in there. My calendar's so empty, it has 13 months. Advent calendar. I don't quite know what an advent calendar is. I've heard of the term before, but I don't think anybody knows what it is. Unless you're some kind of Final Fantasy fan. My calendar has a picture of a tumbleweed, folks. I like the idea of a picture. Write a fireman calendar? My calendar has a picture of fireman skeletons on it. Does that make sense? I'm going to write that down, but I don't think that makes sense. Sometimes only I can sell these jokes, which is both a blessing and a curse. My calendar is a picture of firemen's skeletons on it. Quality Final Fantasy reference, yeah. Andrew Denniser loves it. He's a big, what do you call it? He's into the video game Hearthstone. Check him out. He's starting to become a professional, making his way in the rungs. My calendar is so empty, hipsters have moved into it. Okay, so we definitely got something with empty. And that was a quality suggestion, you know. He's a very funny guy. He's a funny guy. My calendar is so empty, hipsters are moving in.
Matthew has changed his reaction from a heart to a love. Ain't that the truth?
Also, shout out to Tim Dillon gave it a heart. He's a funny guy. You can see him at the stand every once in a while.
I save money on calendars, folks. Don't invest in Hallmark.
I'm still barely visible. I gotta move over. Ooh.
You guys like the back of my head? All right. I had a joke where it was like, every time I get booked, my agent changes his smoke alarm batteries. Because you only do that twice a year. That wasn't how the joke went, but... We'll rewrite it. Maybe we'll give that one another chance. My career is not going well. Every time I get booked, I change my smoke alarm batteries. Okay. That's too cryptic. It's too confusing. But it's just what America needs. Mingus, take me away. Mingus! Every time I get booked, I change my smoke alarm batteries. I like the fireman joke, but it makes no sense. My calendar is a picture of firemen's skeletons on it. My calendar is a picture of dead firemen on it. Uh-oh! Everybody likes a good joke about dead firemen. It's depressing. My calendar is a picture of dead firemen on it. Oh. I have a digital calendar. Blank. So what's up with a digital calendar? You never have to, it never goes bad. It's on the internet, it's on the cloud. Here we go. Here we go. I like the idea of it being on the cloud, and then you can make a pun off a cloud. It's cumulus, folks. I uploaded my calendar to the cloud, and now it's sunny. Well, I upload my jokes to the cloud blank. Right, it's synced. Start making some connections. Word of the day calendar. Cartoon calendar. I organize my calendar chronologically. I could warm up for Win Ben Stein's money. It's nice to see more than a few viewers. I really appreciate it. It's important to stay hydrated. Alright, now I'm just saying what I'm seeing. Alright. Some people have calendars that are dry erase boards. And what we can do, it's wet, it's empty. We didn't do any empty jokes, and we already had a couple. My calendar's so empty you can fit an extra month in it. I really like that one, Zach. Oh, I wish you were still around, Zach. What happened? Oh, that's fine. I guess Zach's dead. No, that's terrible to say. All right, let's see what we got. Valley. I like the idea of an echo. This is very cerebral. My calendar is so empty, when it tells you the date, it echoes, folks. Now, of course, calendars can't talk. But that being, besides that, the joke's great. That joke would be great if calendars could talk. So you need two. It's like a science fiction thing. You can't come up with more than three terms in half an hour or something. Unless you're Leonardo DiCaprio. My calendar's so empty, when it tells you the time, it echoes, folks. Oh boy. This is no longer Mingus. I want to go back and listen to some more Mingus. Mingus! Yeah, you know what? We'll listen to this. We're in the middle of a... Come on, that's a funny joke. Some of my supernatural jokes don't quite land.
Now, if calendars can talk, that joke would be great. I'm already coming up with an apology for that. Somebody book me! When it tells you the time, when it tells you the date, come on, Steven, get it together. Come on, fellas, you're losing your heads. My calendar's so empty, you could fit another month in there. I normally don't like this much percussion in my jazz, not gonna lie. Hang in there. I have a motivational blank poster. Motivational calendar. This is something we can almost revisit. I know I say that quite a bit, but... Laundry's done. Nobody leaving any comments, huh? For old Mr. Jokes? That's okay. I'm just so glad to see all of you. Empty spaces, okay. Eno said, my calendar has so many empty spaces, hipsters moved in. It got gentrified, folks. Gonna ask an old question to Eno Bong there. Trying to go live. Why am I Lulu though? I don't mind some good bass, though. So this one is inspired by Eno's joke. See if Eno gives me the permission. Show off that wedgie. My calendar has so many white spaces, it got gentrified. Finally, I can make fun of white people. You know what other Comedy Central presents I watched recently was I watched Dimitri Martin's and I was losing it. So funny. A guy that is a very polarizing comic. It got...
my calendar has so many white spaces, it got gentrified. But that's not why it got my calendar has so many white spaces, it is gentrified. It is gentrified, folks. Ooh, what is this? Spanish flair. So many empty spaces, I rented out for checkers night at the senior center. Dave Fitzgerald, I love it. And Rob Fitzgerald, his brother, joined. Sorry, folks, I can't, I try with the, this is a little bit too much even for me. Sorry about that, I'm back. Charles Mingus. Mingus is one of those... I'm sorry. Mingus is one of those jazz musicians that sometimes people say, like, oh, jazz is just a bunch of... blah, blah, blah. And I think they think of Mingus when they think of that, because Mingus certainly can go crazy. But in a good way. Hey, we're up to 10 viewers. All right. I guess you probably want me to write some jokes. My calendar has so many white spaces it got gentrified. My calendar has so many empty spaces, I sell it for a storage whatever. What is the name of a storage place? You store it? It's always great on open mic for me to do like 10 jokes in a row about calendars. People don't get sick of that. Manhattan Mini Storage? Is that the one? Which is the one with the ads? American Self Storage. Tuck It Away. What a great name. Sounds like my wedgie. It's amazing. I remember all those ads. Yeah, it's Manhattan Mini Storage, right? I didn't know. Rented out for checkers night at the senior center. I like the words checkers and senior. Anthony Oberbeck joined. Hello, Anthony. Anthony has a hilarious joke. I saw him at the Annoyance the other week, and he says, my family was like the Simpsons growing up, except our eyes were too small. That's a great joke. Oh, man. Digital. My calendar has so many empty spaces, it's called Manhattan Mini Storage. Oh, geez, that's a bad joke. I think we can key into that Joan Rivers specific joke. Where Joan Rivers said, for the 800th time today, Joan Rivers said, I have to wear sunglasses when I look at my calendar because all of the white is bad for my eyes. I have to do something when I look at my calendar because something. I really like the Echoes joke. We're going to test it in a mic. By the way, I'm doing 20 minutes tomorrow at Hashtag Bar in Staten Island. They have me closing out the mic. I have to, but you? My calendar has so many white spaces, it's gentrified, folks. Yeah, that's honestly, that's probably a keeper. Especially I'm performing at a place like Greenwich Village Comedy Club or whatever, like a big urban crowd. What do we got? Let's do this. Maybe we can do a joke that's a little salty, like white boxes. My career has more white boxes than a thing with only white women. My career has more white boxes than The Bachelor, folks, okay? What is something that's overwhelmingly white people besides stand-up comedy? We'll just write it down. What the heck? That one's pretty, Then ABC's The Bachelor. Nevertheless, you could probably just do a whole thing on a calendar with empty box. We're gonna think of one more, and then we're gonna call it. We'll shock a flat, and then we'll quit. For all you RoboCop fans. That dead fireman joke is also pretty funny, if not a little, blue. Echoes 1 is my favorite, but it's pretty cerebral. My calendar's so empty, when it tells you the date, it echoes, folks. Now, if calendars can talk, my calendar has more white boxes than The Bachelor, folks, okay? That one actually has potential, too. I think the ladies will like that one. This next joke's for the ladies. Oh, my goodness. I almost don't want to say it. Because some of you probably know this guy, but there's this comedian that does this joke. He's from Philadelphia. And he goes, oh man, all the ladies are talking about their pH. It's like, what, you got a swimming pool down there? Oh, that's not funny. He's an interesting fella. I haven't seen him in a month. Let's see. Maybe he actually got a real life. I get booked. The last time I wrote something in my calendar, it was buy a new calendar. We'll write that down, but we'll think of another joke. Oh, sorry if I spaced out a little bit back there. I had a family barbecue today, and some of them had some very interesting opinions about what's happening with Black Lives Matter, and it was very fun to sit by and pretend to be asleep. Last time I wrote something on my calendar, it was get a new calendar. I have trouble getting booked. Maybe it's the calendar. My calendar has a picture of dead firemen on it. That's funny. I don't care who you are. That's funny. Get her done. I don't care who you are. That's funny. All right, we have to write a new one. I said we were and we are. All right, we got 5 viewers. You deserve it. Starting to get a little late, though. But that's fine. We'll do 8 minutes. My calendar is so empty, the Pokemon, when you look at it, Pokemon Go. Ah, jeez. The worst part about saying we're going to write one joke and then writing one is that your whole body shuts down. It's telling you you already did what you said you were going to do. Ugh. I have a word of the day calendar. The word is new agent. The word is kombucha. Have you guys heard any good jokes lately? Taylor Swift, huh? It's super effective. Trying to think of the Karate Chop. Sometimes when I end a joke, I do this because I'm not funny. Ugh. Sorry, guys, I'm in a bit of a thoughtful moment right now. Leap year. Come on. Let's think of this. Hang in there. Recycled. Order. Just empty. Think of something empty. Empty had so much good stuff. Something that now I'm just like looking at the words aren't even symbols anymore, they're just kind of like smudges. I'm just kind of looking at smudges. My calendar is more white boxes than The Bachelor, folks. Okay, honestly, that Bachelor is kind of, I think that's going to be the best one. The word of the day, the word is kombucha. To me, kombucha is such a funny... There was an open mic I was at, and it was going so great that everybody started off with, what's your favorite racial slur? And I went up and I said, my favorite racial slur is kombucha, people. And one person in the crowd laughed until they cried, so that was a good feeling. It was a good buddy of mine, my friend Dan Perlman. He's a good man. He's a Caroline's. Look at me. Let's see. My motivational calendar said there's always plan B.
I almost think this could be a hole in today it said below it ever. And today it said there's always tomorrow. Boom. We're done!
Alright. My agent booked my calendar. He got it used. Eno!
Yeah, damn right. Yeah, thank you, Eno. I appreciate it. And Charles. Oh, we're down to one viewer. Well, what a treat. This one viewer, I hope you like it. Oh.
Don't blame it on love. I couldn't even if I tried.
Okay. This was our joke web. Not a bad joke web. These were our jokes today. Whoop. My career is not going well. I still haven't bought a calendar. My career is not going well. Does anybody need a calendar? I got booked. I'm on 4 shows this year. My calendar has a picture of a tumbleweed. My calendar has a picture of firemen skeletons on it. My calendar has a picture of dead firemen on it. My career is not going well. Every time I get booked, I change my smoke alarm batteries. My calendar is so empty when it tells you the date, it echoes. My calendar has so many white spaces, it got gentrified. My calendar has so many white spaces, it's gentrified. My calendar has more white boxes than The Bachelor. The last time I wrote something on my calendar, it was buy a new calendar. I have a motivational calendar. Today it said there's always tomorrow. That one kind of flows well. Might not be great. You're never done writing. Make sure you put a number. And we also have our joke hospital, which we'll work on in a week or two. And the bringbacks, which we'll figure out later. Okay. Plugs. Hey, what's up? My wedgie time. Let's see. Steve Whalen, MrJokes.com. StevWhalenMrJokes.com. Steve Whalen, Mr. Jokes on Instagram. At Real Mr. Jokes on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. I do this every Sunday and Thursday at 11 p.m. And every Saturday I riff cheesy movies on Saturdays at midnight. What else is going on? I'm on a couple shows this week. So, have a good one. It was so nice to see everybody.